This version of the bottle tornado type generator, I'll go through the principle again, using kites on an inflated band to drive around and round, just like a looping parafoil, all ganged together, transferring torque to a following bicycle wheel at the bottom as the whole thing spins. Ooh, that spin went a wee bit off there, sorry. So here's the top, lifted top. There's the bottom, where you've got your power takeoff. Now, the difference in the system to earlier ones is I have an elastic to the centre of each kite blade, and the force between each layer is transferred to the point where that elastic joins the next band. The reason being, as that stretches, that elastic stretches, as more power and more wind goes through, it collapses the kite shape slightly. Okay, so you pull that line here, this is going to extend, but these two lines on the side are going to come in and crimple this inflating band, and that line's going to drop down, making a more curved C shape and giving less of the kite to the wind, showing less face to the oncoming wind. Therefore, you're going to get a smoother output as the wind picks up from your tornado. I call this a tornado, this kite configuration. It seems very simple to describe mathematically, and take out all the line lengths and set everything now. So it's at the stage where it's really worth trying, worth giving it a go. I think we could generate some pretty useful power with this. Certainly, if we had like a hydrogen chitin or a top mesh holding this up, it seems that would be a well-lived long-term solution. Yeah, it's going to be the sort of thing that could stay up, stay airborne, and be very useful. Let me know what you think.